The following video aims to depict what is the ideal technique of draping the eye. Now, with the COVID times, we take extra precautions, and the mask that the patient wears is secured to the nose using a micropore tape across the patient's nose. This ensures that whenever the patient is breathing, we don't have the air accidentally coming towards the operating field. We now proceed with cleaning the eye with betadine as demonstrated below. So the surgeon uses betadine in a cotton bud, and we clean first the area of the lid margins and then move to the area above, up to the brow and up to the exposed part of the forehead. The same procedure is proceeded inferiorly, where the lower lid margin is first cleaned and the rest of the exposed lower part of the face is also cleaned. It is extremely important that this area be dried completely. If it were not to get dried completely, it sometimes causes the drape not to adhere to the patient's skin, which gives you the unwanted exposure of the skin and or the lashes. As you can see, this area, the one that is blue, which has got the metal clip to it, is the part that houses the bag that holds on to the infusion fluid that comes out of the eye, and therefore this needs to always be temporally oriented. So we turn around, and I think it's important to get it right for the person who's draping to actually slip in the fingers in the lower part, because I find that that helps me give a good adhesion of the drape to the eye. Assistant now will use two cotton buds to open up the eye and to keep the lashes away from the operating field, while the person adhering the drape on actually sticks the drape on to the eye firmly in a manner just depicted. Okay, we now proceed with opening up the drape and let's see what we have. A well adhered drape would actually appear like this. There are no pockets of any area where the drape is not perfectly stuck onto the patient's skin. This clearly and completely segregates the patient's eye from the rest of the face. We then proceed with opening up the drape, where you cut it down in its middle, all the way in the exposed part of the eye. Okay? And having achieved that, the next and final step is placement of the speculum. So first the upper and then the lower, the choice is yours. And then the speculum is exposed just enough to allow for adequate exposure to carry out the surgery comfortably. A quick recap. As you can see, the fingers slide in through just a thin layer of the drape, and with the cotton bud, the lashes are moved away and the upper lid is pulled up and the drape is stuck in place, making sure that the inner aspect touches against the base of the nose. In this manner, you will be able to consistently achieve an optimal draping of the lids. When operating on a patient under topical anesthesia, however, it may be slightly more challenging because of the patient's tendency to close and squeeze the eyes. So the patient has to be explained what is being done, and then we go ahead with draping. Ab hum wo kagaz aapki aankh ke upar rakhenge. Jor se band mat kariye, theek hai? Right. So the assistant now tries and opens out the eyes, while the surgeon then puts on the drape carefully in a manner described earlier. Then in the usual manner, the polydrape is cut down its middle. And sometimes when you have lashes that are turning downwards, just the use of a forceps and sweeping the forceps like this would actually get the lashes to move away under the drape. And then this is followed by the introduction of the speculum.
and opening up of the speculum just to give you adequate exposure.